your chance to be rude. Hey kid, don't ever let them get inside your head. They'll tell you what to do in life instead of everything you know that you could get. Don't let them guide your life towards regret. I'll fight for what I love with every breath. My past is filled with things I won't forget. I use them all to push me to my best. So treat the worst of times just like a test. If only I could go back in time, I'd tell myself that everything will end up alright. Just push yourself, test yourself, figure out what you like, and find your limits, don't be rigid, always work towards a prime. Surround yourself with open minds, people can change your life. A few friends with intent can help you feel alive. Find a passion, take some action, and with a little time, just be patient, make a statement, try to enjoy your life. They'll try to kick you while you're down. They wanna rise up while you drown. They wanna fill your head with doubt. They're silently scared that you'll figure it out. I'll make it look like I'm losing. Won't bother hiding my bruises. And when they finally think you're wounded, then it's your chance to be ruthless. I can see that they compare. I think everyone's against me. Maybe something in the air. Am I paranoid? I swear a void is forming and they're scared. I walk a straight path. Not many can say that. I like to play fast. Cross me and there's payback. You better pray that I don't see your face at any place that I go. I know you hate that. I've been doing fine. I'm not wasting any more time. I live for the fight and the climb. I think that the pain that's deep inside is what defines. So I won't give up, I'm gonna make it to the top. I don't care what's in my way, I swear I'm never gonna stop. I could fall flat on my face and I swear I won't give back up. Cause I don't deserve a thing and the road ahead is tough. They'll try to kick you while you're down. They wanna rise up while you drown. They wanna fill your head with doubt. They're silently scared that you'll figure it out. I'll make it look like I'm losing. Won't bother hiding my bruises. And when they finally think you're wounded, then it's your chance to be ruthless.
Omaha, what's up, Talon? What's up, Brian? Thanks, B, for the like. Poll real quick, which do you prefer? Do you prefer Nations, Manu, or the special esports events that sometimes pop up for the GTWS? Me, personally, I prefer Manu. As imbalanced as the game is, I just feel like a bunch of people picking a bunch of different cars just makes great racing, and it's just really fun for me. But you let me know what... You let me know what you decide in the poll, and let's get started with Nations round two. I'm not particularly quick here. I tried finding the pace. Something about the track is just not agreeing with me. But we're gonna try our best. What's the worst that's gonna happen? Really, I just think it's just the hairpins in this last turn that get me. think everything else I just, like, I have pretty much down. But it's the two hairpins, the left-hander and the right-hander, and just that very last corner I seem to lose time on. We definitely have enters, so we're good to go. We're gonna at least have a good strategy. Can't possibly go in there without the intermediates, right? It'd be horrible. We'd be one of the guys that would fly right off into this turn. Another thing I'm kind of struggling with, too, is saving tires in this car. Like, usually I'm alright at saving the tires, but I can't seem to make it to lap 15 as well as, like, Grove did. That was definitely the optimal strat that week. What's great about that week is we ended up finishing that week very solid. We had a lot of wins there. Gained a lot of DR. But yeah, it definitely started out pretty funny. I think if I can qualify with, like, a 0.5, I'd be pretty happy. I think that's my goal, it's a 46.5 for qual. Johnny, give me a hug, because I'm not going to be able to hug you when it starts. Alright, love you. You can say hi.
Hi, guys, and by the way, whoever's a Seahawks fan is allowed.
Thanks for the message, buddy. Whoever is a Seahawks fan is allowed in the chat. Wait till he's a little older to tell him. Yo, what's up, McRacer? You only like the colors? Well, that's fair enough. Yeah, how did your appointment go, McRacer? Hopefully it went well, bro. Bronco country, let's ride. I guess you guys ain't riding no more, right? Yeah, now that he's not around, I haven't told him yet that not a lot of people like our team. At least in this area. It's like Santa Claus to him. Dude, every single interview, Broncos country, let's ride. My favorite one is when he had that loss and he was like, Broncos country. And as he walked away, he was just like, let's ride. He was like so defeated. Let's ride, guys. Broncos country. Let's ride. Oh man, that sounds painful, bro. I see like some mixed things about Russell Wilson with the Broncos. You know, there was reports about him reportedly getting cut or not being with the team next season. And then I seen the GM saying he was possibly going to be with the team next season. So I have no clue what's going on over there. You guys are dysfunctional as hell. Oh, look at the baby face. Yeah, it's all gone. I shaved it just for you. It's my present. It sounds like it hurt. Well, I'm glad you weren't in, you know, I'm glad you weren't suffering today. I guess the time spent there sucked enough, right? Gonna miss the chafing. Oh man. All cute and snuggly. There you go. Thanks, man. Appreciate that. Thanks for the like. We need to find the real mullet. It's as real as it gets, guys. It doesn't get any more real. Ooh, let's check out the livery, though, right quick. It's a Sonic X Japanese livery. It's pretty dope. They're flaunting the Mega Drive and some Sonic the Hedgehog 1. I like it. Not too bad. Not too bad. AI generated mullet. Yeah, there you go. They forgot the beard. Battle of the Forces of Evil. I like it. I'm hoping for a good race just for you guys. Yeah, I'm going to need some help, guys. I am the true mullet. Looking like P5 is very reasonable in this lobby. P5 or better. Even with the, you know, even with the pace disadvantage I'm going to have, I think I should be all right. Let's just say hi to Lester, Grove, Pierman, Simi, Vogs. Good to see you again. Have a good race. First, let's go. Definitely didn't quit streaming. Honestly, we technically only missed one day, which was Monday. Stupid sausages. No cap, because we streamed Friday. We just didn't do Nations on Saturday. And then we missed Monday because everybody was home. Stop the cap! Thanks, Plaka. Good to see you in here. Look like a baby? I told you guys, I'm a 32-year-old teenager. He said I told you not to shave. Definitely lost some time to the guy behind us. Bless you. We're gonna pit lap 15. Might burn up the tires doing it, but that's alright. This might be a high 46. We missed a shift. darn. I think it's still an improvement, though, just by not much. It's all right. We're going to be doing plenty of double shifting. Okay, we got our goal of a 0.5. Got our goal. I'm happy with that. But we'll be doing plenty of double shifting for next race, 100%. Thanks, Truth. Welcome back. This is the second race. Are you doing the race, Dom? Hopefully you are. You're fast. Have a good race. Good luck. Yup, can't wait. It's going to be my favorite combo of all of GTWS. No, I'm not racing. Fair enough. Oh, hell yeah. Good job. I didn't even check the points. I'll check that right quick. I'm definitely the AI mullet, not the real one. This might be a pretty fun little race between me and Grove. So P5 and 6, 284 and 270. Yep, Grove is here. I do have the inside on him, so we might be able to get that overtake. Plus, it's a grid start, and, you know, I'll try to toot my own horn here, but we got some pretty fast reaction time. All them fighting games. So far, Nations is not something that everybody likes. Special events, Emmanuel is crushing it in a poll. Yes, yes, that's the best tip. Yeah, it's top split. Just not a lot of top drivers are doing the event. Yeah, all the way up to P12 was in the 46s. Thank you. I'm not sure. I don't remember him. If he did, he usually says Omahay. He might go for a dive. Yeah, a really bad lap. I've got a big old sign on my car that says hit me. I think Dom must have put it in there before the race started. Good answer. Y'all above my pay grade. Thank you. Nobody wants to work with us today. Overcooked that turn. Howdy, what's up, Knights? Groves and P5. I didn't mean it. I just, I don't know. I felt like two things happened there. Like, we broke slightly late and he broke very early. Oh, absolutely, man. Yeah, we're doing slot 3. Especially after this disaster. I want to judge my pace first. It's still doing 48s. I think it might still be faster for me to stay out and wait. I think others will try and take that chance. We are still gapping Simi. We're gonna catch JDM. We still have spots to gain like this. I'm way off pace to the front guys. I'm not off pace to the guys around me though. Like pitting now would mean I lose to these guys 100%. If you guys see what I'm talking about. Like, P8's still on the table. If we pit, like, I feel like we're going to be racing for P12. And that's if we do a really good job with the hard tires in the rain. Omaha, what's up, Jackum? Jakeum? Jakeem? We just gotta keep him in the 48s. And apparently JDM has worse damage than us. That's close. I'm not sure. I lost a lot of time in that last sector. That's the question. Do I fix the bumper or not? Probably. It's probably just a 1 second or 2 second fix. Worst that can happen is we don't get seventh. Yeah, it might be something really tiny. It's just enough to lose time in like two major spots, really. Like, we lose a little time here, and we lose a bunch of time down the front straight. Might have got away with pitting there, to be honest. Yeah, I know the weather's scripted. We have no front end right now. Wow, that .001 costed us so much time. Like, so much time. Like, we were losing more than 2 seconds a lap on that tiny, tiny little bit of aerodynamic damage. It's hilarious. Got hit again. That's four times we got hit this race. Thank you. Yeah, we just got more damage, though. A miserable race, to be honest. Yeah, thanks. I kind of like the hay in there, Lewis. To be quite honest, the 30-some seconds is around the pit loss. So, I mean, it would have been close. This is a podium if I had the beard? Yeah. VR cutouts. That's what happened to Vogs, is VR went out. Yeah, fair enough. It, like I said, it's rough to say what could have happened. It's still like around the pit loss, though. At very least, I think I'm still trying to fight for 7th. Like, I definitely don't catch Herman or Vlad. Who's that in mullet seat? He said, I won, in my opinion. So we know that we definitely go again. Yes, I had chicken and cheesy taters and some green beans. Why didn't I flinch? Like I said, two things happened there. We're in GTWS, you know, and if he did that to me, I'd rather him just keep going than waiting, because you never know what could happen. But, like, really two things happened. He broke very early, and then for me, like, I broke slightly late, you know, and there's, like, what are we going to do? Are we both just going to wait? Like, I honestly, like, I really think that if I was in his shoes, I would want the guy just to keep going. Like, if we're in daily racing or lobby racing, then wait or whatever, but GTWS event, just keep going, man. Is what it is. We'll talk about it after. Yeah, absolutely. It's like, I got to his bumper, like, fairly quickly. Like, there was a big gap, and I was just, you know, I was actually kind of surprised that I got to him, to be, you know, to be quite honest. Some hot chicken nachos? Nice. Nice, that's awesome. Thanks, man. We're gonna definitely do this last lot and hopefully a better result. Should be a bit, you know, less competition overall. So we should do better because of that. Yeah, we gotta do our little promotion thing. We can't forget that part. Yo, Dom. Ciro has never had a hamburger. Yeah, hopefully, Knights. You should. I'm sure if you had, like, around 40 to 30% of that bar, I'll definitely see you next race. Yeah, he told me he's never had a hamburger. I'm like blown away. He's never had a hamburger and he's never had chocolate milk. I told him he hasn't lived until he had one of those two things. Like, he should order a fat double cheeseburger, right? With everything on it. Because he has no clue how he likes his cheeseburgers. He needs to order a fat double cheeseburger with everything on it. And then tall glass of chocolate milk. Like, he needs to. I'm blown away. I can't tell you how blown away I was to find out these things. I rated, like, drinks right quick, right? I was just like, you know, I was like, coffee is pretty good. Like, once you get, like, how you do coffee, right? Coffee becomes, like, the third, like, top three, like, best beverages, right? And my list went chocolate milk, number one. Number two is tea, like, iced tea or any way you make tea, because I like hot tea as well. And then I was like, third is coffee, right? He's just like, he just goes, yeah, I've never had chocolate milk. And I was just like, wow. You don't understand the hype about chocolate milk? Look, I'll tell you what the hype is about chocolate milk, right? I live on T2, by the way, right? This is the hype. You get Hershey syrup container, right? Hershey syrup, and you get milk. Whatever milk, it could be soy milk, right? And all you do is you just pour that in there and forget that you're pouring it in because you need extra. And then you stir that up. It's the best thing ever. Number one, Uno. No, not Nesquik. Nesquik is trash. It's got to be Hershey syrup. It's got to be Hershey syrup. You got to trust the mola. I'm a fat guy. All right, cool. I guess I am a female child then. I don't drink soy milk. Soy milk is terrible. It's like the worst thing ever. I use the good old-fashioned whole white milk. I don't like almond milk either. I think it's terrible as well. Yeah, cow's milk only. I wouldn't even give it to my cats. All right, listen. I'm going to start a race at 9. We'll watch nights here. If we can get people. There's only nights in here, so he's already in the chat. Well, I'll be right back. I'm going to go get my second favorite drink, iced tea. The goat is chocolate milk. The goat. Alright, McRacer, you should join too, man. Alright, we're back. We got some peoples in here. I wonder if KP's gonna do the last lot. No practice. Jester left the room. I wonder if he lagged out or if he just doesn't want to do it. Where the hell is the... It's all the way down here. Usually these practice lobbies fill right up in between slots. It's just not a fun combo. Like, the rain part is pretty dynamic, it's different, but it's just not a fun combo overall. Usually it doesn't even matter though, you know, usually like I said, these lobbies will fill right up. It's like a 47.8. It was a horrible lap. Alright, it's not as bad as I thought it was. It's still pretty bad. Missed that. Should be a 46 at least. Oh man. maybe. It depends if we get the settings for it. He has a lobby up? Interesting. Dampers only for the car settings? I think there might be more to it though. Like what I'm talking about is the race settings itself, like tire wear, laps. At least they give us the good stuff. I know. That's going to be awesome in higher lobbies. I might have to watch a few of the lower lobby streams because it is going to be hectic. We got nabbed for cheating. Horrible. Thank you. All right, man. Oh, hold a second. This is Brigsby and the viewers joined to say hi, but I don't see no Brigsby. Hello, Brigsby. That is a valid question for Scotty. There he is. Thanks, B. Appreciate it, man. I don't get it. /113 right now? Ooh. 1:13 lap. At Interlagos, let's go. I'll take some food too, B. Just make me a plate of whatever you're having. My wheel just broke. What's up, Josh, aka J Dog? Thank you. The reverse mullet. What do you mean? We got a new sub. Give me a second. I'll see what you are. Welcome to the channel, Miles. Miles, you're not a sub yet? Oh my gosh. It's good to see you, man. Appreciate it. I thought you were here forever ago. I told you guys I would look like a 32-year-old teenager. I told you. Maybe that's why I did it, just to show you. Hey Chippy, appreciate that. We were just talking about chocolate milk. Oh wow. You guys saw nothing. So don't tell the world. Yeah, we got snow too. I'm in northeastern Pennsylvania. Right by Scranton. What? What is it that we're guessing? I would have never guessed. Thanks, bro. Hopefully you have a good, be a good morning for you right now. Lurking Heat? There you go. That should be the name of a fast food restaurant. Omaha, what's up there, Baku? Like the lobby will just not rain. It's alright. There you go. Lurk and eat. And only serve sandwiches. That's all you need. A sandwich and chips. What's up, Skeletor? I'm doing well. Hopefully you're doing well. You wouldn't eat there, Joe's Lurking Eat? You're missing out. Missing out, J-Dog. Missing out big time. They make your sandwiches into sandwiches. We all know a sandwich is just a way better sandwich. We all know this. Nova shopping. That's not far. Not far at all. It's like 45 minutes away from me. I don't know Quarries or Montrose though. Interesting, that's cool. That's cool. I'm gonna check the poll real quick. Nations is still getting beat up. I'm gonna hold out hope that rain will come in the last lap and it will downpour. No? We missed last round. I would have been really happy to do last round because we were fairly quick. And then, you know, this is the round we get stuck with. I did not see the Genesis yet. I should absolutely look at that. But alright, Puck, you have a good one, man. A Genesis is definitely a car we're going to need, because that car seems to be the meta more often than not. We got no rain whatsoever. Come on, PD. Nice, nice, Chippy. That's gonna be fun. I hope you guys are looking forward to that. It's gonna be a blast. He literally dragged him there. Good. I love rewatching the VODs too. Like, they do a good job commentating the event. So usually, like, I'll race and then rewatch what happened, and then I get mad that they miss all the action. Yeah, absolutely. Absolutely. I think it's, like, probably one of the better events or leagues that's being ran right now. The only issue that I have with NRL is the combos are so crazy. But, I mean, the combos being crazy makes it volatile, which always gives you, like, a level of mystery of who could potentially win, who has the better strategy. Did not rain. No rain whatsoever. Game hates us. Nice. Baku's pretty quick, ain't he? He ain't too shabby. We already know that Dom isn't going to be racing again. We already know. He was trolling us. I should have showed you the lobby setting, because the lobby setting absolutely has rain in it. Oh man, this makes so much sense why we lost. We have bad oil. Oil is bad. Just always sense the angry face. That's actually his happy face. Just so you know, I have a hunch that Dom and SDS are the same person. I'm just saying. They're the exact same person. Alright, gonna use the bathroom quick. Fill up my teacup. I'll be back. As Dom tries to tell us he's not actually SDS. We know it's you. Yeah, don't forget the oil there, Knights. Knights, are you streaming? Let us know if you're streaming. I don't know, Dom. I think I'm on to you, man. I think I'm on to you.
I think that's why you had the profile pic change. So you can cover your USA account or North American account with your other account. You're caught. I've cracked the code. Nice. He's going to try and do all of them. Is he trying to get golds or is he just trying to get like bronze and move on? You can call me anything you want for the right price. Yeah, $20 is $20. He said, what up, Pinky? There you go. That's a perfect response when people call you Brain. But I mean, you're forever Brain now because Johnny said you're Brain. So you'll never be able to get away from it. Well, there he is. What's up, J2K? Appreciate you stopping by. Fellow Corvette driver. It's too late, B. Once Johnny called him Brain, it's forever now. It's forever. Brian is forever Brain. Mini Mullet has the last say. See, I called him Brain in chat just because I suck at spelling. English is hard. Whopper and a Big Mac. I'm just gonna reset. The only way I'd be able to hear it, B, is if you were reading out loud. Pinky and the Stinky.
I don't think he meant to. I gotta send you a video of the worst game I've ever seen in my life. Don't let me forget. I gotta send it to you. I've actually been thinking about playing terrible games on the channel. Like the worst games imaginable. I think that'd be pretty fun to play, like, the worst games ever. And considering nobody would buy them, you'd never have to worry about somebody being like, hey, I don't want to watch this playthrough because I want to see you play this terrible game. No, it's if you've watched the Walking Dead series, right, you should look up this game called The Walking Dead Destinies. Horrible. This game is trash, man. It's like the worst game ever. Like, it would have been a bad game if it came out for the PlayStation 2. Yo, what's up, Jason? Welcome back. It is so bad, B. I don't even know how it's possible they made a game so bad in today's, like, technology. Like, how does that happen? Sean BK, hello. Welcome back. Good to see you. Some more time out, Brixby, please. How did you do, Sean? One-minute penalties. Did you pit? You might have forgot to pit. That'll definitely give you the 1 minute. Yeah, there's a mandatory pit. You have to pit. If you don't pit, you get a 1 minute penalty. Yeah, you have to pit. We've all been there. We've all done that. It's all right. Happens to all of us. No, you don't even have to change tires. You just have to go in. I don't know if you get another slot, but when you do this slot, make sure you pit. It's actually been here for quite some time. Like, I've done it before in a daily race. Yeah, I didn't look at the race requirements, did not see the minimum pit stop one, didn't pit, and yep, we lost. Dude, I'll be honest. I do not like this combo. I just struggle at this track. That's good to know there, J-Dog. Well, you know what? At the end of the day, at least you know why you got the minute penalty. You know, so if you decide to go again, you won't get a minute this time. I have full faith that you will pit. Let's see if I can get to this line before a minute 46. Or, you know what, if they made it rain earlier, like if they made it rain at like lap 7, you know, and it was just like a splash where you absolutely needed to be on like intermediate tires or wets, that would have been interesting. Because then you would have had people actually pitting another time to try and catch the people that would stay on intermediates. Like say if it like rained lap 7. I fully believe that they don't really think too hard on these combos. Why are red and red the same word pronounced differently? I'm confused. See what I did there? Did you see what I did? The T is not silent in mountain. It is not silent in mountain. Like I am reading a book, but I read it last night. Red and red. You got me. You got me. Alright. Ooh, McDottie's in here. He made it to the top split. Boom. Grove. McNudie? only 328. I've actually got the second highest DR in the room. Interrupted? I'm not even going to try to read that word there, J-Dog. I'll hurt myself trying to do that. Thanks, Pyro. I'm just enjoying this. Don't be mad, bro. I'm having fun picking on the Dom. I don't know. I woke up and it was gone. Beard just left. Darn. Well, you know what? The next race you get to do that has a minimum pit stop, you will not forget. Thanks, man. You too, if you're racing.
I can't believe how bad I struggle here. I'm gonna put Fuji as one of my worst tracks, like, in the game. Every single person is in 46s, except for P12 and back. So I don't think I like Fuji at all, like, period. Is it? You like the music? So we gotta get to 241. Let's do 41. So P7 or higher. We're starting at P7. You know what, though? We'd probably still be stuck using the Mazda. I almost guarantee you that we'd still be stuck in the Mazda. Yeah. It is. I was telling KP, the car is like 300 pounds lighter than the Corvette and GR4. 300 pounds. Somebody messed up. How is it 300 pounds lighter? If it tells you to do it, you have to do it. Like, specifically, this race calls for it. It's alright, man. Ask away. Not particularly fond of FF either. Thank you. McDonald just slammed into us. Two, three. Another person. I know, everybody's just racing me hard as hell. This guy has damage or something. All right, B, go do those things. See ya.
Thank you, McNaughty. Good teamwork. Yay, we're moving forward finally. Gotta break a little earlier for that. We gained, what, almost 5/10 on P5 now? If we could do that every lap, we have a chance at P5. Fronts are hurting, though. I think his fronts are also hurting. All right. That's a second and a tenth. Almost a second and two tenths. That's fine. Nobody's surviving that lap. So I'm okay with that. We are close to slipstream. We're gonna have a dead left front. Just kind of survive this one last lap. You have no tread, basically. So close.
Woo!
That was a lot of overtakes this race. Let me just bring it home. So many overtakes. Just bring it home. We tried. There's so much just elbows out. We tried. It's a good race though. Congrats to McNaughty. That is his second win on us ever. Yeah, it's a good race. Yeah, P4 was like right there. Like, look at that. Like, what is that? Half a second from P4 to P7? Yeah, we had to fight back, like, big time. We had to use like all of our tire. We had to fight all the way back. That's it. McNaughty. Who is else in there? Is that dude McNaughty? Where the hell is the other dude? Oh, we got him. Nara's right. Dude, it was so tight. Four people was just like going in on there. It was super intense. That was one of our best races ever. Can't be mad at that at all. So can we... Oh, we could start doing this. So let's check out what the combo is. Thirty laps, guys. This is gonna be 40 minutes. It's a 30-lap race. What settings do they allow? Hold on. Car settings. So just damping. Oh. I was hoping just a little tiny more. This is gonna be good fun. We're gonna start practicing for that tomorrow morning, 100%. But I kind of want to watch that last lap. Those last two laps was just so fun. I had so many overtakes. Oh, you seen that, guys, right? You seen McDirty over there? Let's see what actually happened to him. McDirty trying to take us out. Confirmed. I'm going to send him that picture. You know, never mind what happened in the back. I'm just going to send him that picture right there. Be like, what was that, McNaughty? What was that, dude? I thought we were friends. That is how it kicked off for us. And then we get stuck on the outside. Like every single turn. Oh, he's running into us again. Well, that time Gav got us. To be honest, I didn't even think he was that close up on the right side at that point. I thought he was far enough behind us. Oh man, leave it to JDM with the dive bomb of the century. Wait, look at this! Are we? Oh, Like, we're down a tenth. Let's see how bad it actually gets going forward here. Alright, so the worst that we get down is 10th. We have to fight all the way back. Like, how far is this guy from us? Like, yo, he's all the way up here. Alright, so this is our first move. I think we do like an overtake a lap from here on out. Nice little slot in. Alright, now we get Steve. Alright, not this lap. McNaughty's next. I love doing this to people, making them think I'm gonna dive. And look, he understeers right in. It's my favorite thing. It's like, oh, I'm gonna dive! And then they just lock up. Definitely going to be a move. Alright, so now it's Steve's turn. We're coming for you, Steve. I think this is the outside pass. Yeah, I hate the Mazda. Here's the outside pass right here for sure. I could watch that one again, honestly. This one was great. Go to Steve's point of view on this one. That was great racing between me and Steve. It's a great pass. This guy I took a little bit. I had to get a really good run on him. Because he was fighting like super hard. I knew if we got past him though, that we'd be able to chase down those guys in front. Oh yeah. Usually me and Steve race really well. So this was so frustrating to me. I was just like, this was so frustrating. He breaks so late here. I'm gonna pause it. Hey, he's still not on the brakes. Look how late he breaks. And I couldn't turn in. He made the corner somehow. I feel like if I would have broke that late, I would have been way off the track. Thank you.
Then there's this one. Yeah, I just think I surprised him that I was on the inside. And then he gets mad at me. Dive bomb for this. There's nowhere to go for me. I know, man. It's P6 was the position, I guess. You get P6, you win the whole thing. And then me and McNaughty, teamwork right here. Look at this teamwork. He knew he was had. He knew it. Teamwork made the stream work. Yeah, see what I did there? Alright, let's get all the way up here. Because our tires are dead at some point. McNaughty did a great job of sticking with us, by the way. Yeah. Is that what it is? P6 is the shout out from Steve. Super GT. I don't even know why I called him Steve. I don't know him like that. Oh, this was also frustrating. Smashing a wall. That should be 3 seconds easy. I'm just saying. That should be a 3 second penalty. This is a clean move. I thought we were good. I thought we were good at this point. I really did. We were not good. It's all because of this right here. If I don't miss this breaking point, we're gold. Yeah, we see we broke slightly. Too late. Too late. Should have broke, like, before the sign. See, if we did not miss this, we were good. That ruined everything. Just brought everybody right back in the slipstream. Poor Steve. All right, I'm just gonna watch this whole last lap. I was also frustrated with this. Like, oh my gosh. They're single file. I got this guy on my inside. What tire is he on? He's on hards. This guy dove us here. Oh my gosh, so far back. I don't know how he gets it stopped though. That's what's nuts to me. He's able to get it stopped. Oh man, look, McNaughty trying to take out Rosado. You guys all saw that. Ha ha ha.
What, Gav? Or Rosado? Rosado was pretty rough to race with. It was still very fun. I had the run, guys. You guys were just beating each other up here. In real life, all those bumps would have slowed you guys way down. I'm just saying. I mean, I wasn't expecting him to dive me from that far back. And I'm trying to take a good line to, like, be in front. If I go and I cover, I get smacked. I guarantee you, I get smacked. It's a good race, though. But, McNaughty, you have something that you have to explain here. Like, what is this? What happened here? I think you got some splaining. We all saw you punt the mullet. I have picture proof. I don't see anybody getting hit on this picture. All I see is you driving right through me. I see you driving right through me. Hell yeah, dude. McNaughty did a great job. Other than him trying to hit me right here. Other than him trying to knock me off into the distance, trying to take me out on the very first turn of the race. McNaughty did a great job. What do you mean? There's nobody there. Look, it's just me and you. I'm going to post this in the McNaughty chat and just be like, picture proof that McNaughty is very dirty. My client pleads, nuh-uh. I mean, this is what I see. Yo, but you got damage there? Interesting. You did really well for having damage. I gotta say, though, the team worked down the front straight to get past Gav. Like, how sick was that? That was the best. I was flashing my lights, and I was hoping you understood what I was trying to do. So I was just like, dude, if you just bump me past this guy, we're good. We're clear. Yeah, he was brutal. And I did see the start. I did see you get bumped. But still, I got a picture that proves that you hit me. Start in reverse. Look at the dive bomb of the century. Here we go. He wins the race there. Clearly. If he gets that move done, he wins the race right there. That's what it comes down to. We just gotta understand his logic. Yeah, that was good stuff, man. Great race from you. Great race. All right, guys, I'm gonna bounce off of here. I'll see you guys tomorrow morning for some nations practice. I kind of can't wait to, you know, dive into it, to be honest. So hopefully I see you guys all tomorrow morning. If you are not subbed, please give me a sub. Please give me a like. Appreciate y'all. Enjoy. Have a good night.